कॉइन प्लीज।
हेड एंड टेल यू कॉल
हेड हेड इज द कॉल। न्यूज फ्रॉम द सेंटर इज फ्लाइंग ऑरिक्स हैव वन द टॉस एंड डिसाइडेड टू बॉल फर्स्ट। बैक टू यू।
Flying Oris won the toss and they decided to field. Well, this is something which was not expected. But Sunil, would you like to give a quick reaction to this?
I think winning the toss and electing to field first is not a bad decision because you want to know how much target you are chasing. So it's a smart move according to you.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And as we decided to field, this is a surprising factor. So let's have a quick look at the team, right?
Absolutely. Keep an eye on Faisal Khan because Pearl Gladiators are going to bat first. Faisal Khan, Adnan, Ilyas are going to open. And one down is Shoaib Maqsood, their captain. Very, very dangerous player. Also, their wicketkeeper, Sheikh Mohammad Raheel. So these four batsmen are going
to... Bilawal Iqbal. And there we go. First delivery, clipped down to the leg side. That will carry to the boundary. Opens with a four.
Can't ask for more. Opens with a four. This is a...
Cuts it down to short third man. And a direct hit. Out. Overs. 8 for 1. Pearl Gladiators, last delivery of the over coming in. It's time going for a mighty Hoik and six. First six of the tournament. Faisal is mighty, mighty pleased. And at the end of two overs, Gladiators are 14 for 1.
I don't give him another over, which is going to his last over. Look at that, talking about swing and this.
Down the leg side of the pads, that will be 4. Going to wait for the umpire's signal. Yes, it is leg bias, but it doesn't matter. To bat, Maqsood, the captain, next man in, Ilyas, and this time off the edge and taken. So that's success number 2 for. Next one has been Hoik and over point. That is the second six of the innings.
So Arsh, quite an over ambitious shot, but if you get a six off your first ball, well, you are here for some entertainment.
They see Arshad walking down the track this time, over extra cover, 4 runs. Refreshing themselves at the end of 5 overs, the players are getting ready to get back into the action. Spectators glued to all the action, hoping for a lot more of big hits. Strike rate of less than 100. Is going to hurt any team. Harmandeep.
Using his feet and clean bowled. Finally, Harmandeep Singh gets some reward. Arshad, the danger man, is out for 15. 48 for 2. Now, Pearl Gladiators. 2 runs in the 5 deliveries and picked up a wicket also.
Just one more delivery is one more delivery to go in this over. Picked up a wicket of his first delivery, Harmandeep, in this over.
Great.
Man under it and falls between 2 and rolls over the rope for 4. So ends the over with a boundary. 8 overs gone. Gladiators 56 for the loss of 3 wickets.
Mere nana ka naam unse kafi milta hai.
High in the air and taken.
Asif.
Asif it is. Asif Abul Rashid. Another local lad. Looked like he was... Oh, he's saying he lost it for a while in the night sky. But
for honesty, umpires didn't have to go upstairs to the TV umpire for that. Great shot. This is 3rd, 6th of the innings. This is what the crowd is expecting more to see. Duwari cannot be more pleased. seeing his national batsman scoring that big one. 10 balls remaining in this innings.
Hussain Talat, the captain. This is picked up just inside the rope. And there's an appeal, yes! Second run out of the innings. Got it in the middle. It's going the distance. Connects well, does Ilyas. Score reaching 74 now, bringing some smiles into the Pearl Gladiators dugout
and in the VIP arena as well.
I think there's a psychological mark that Gladiators would be trying to hit. Back-to-back sixes, it's taken them to 80. Still two more deliveries to go. They're very comfortable at the end of five overs when they were just 37, but they've pulled things back. Penultimate delivery. On to the stumps and out. Yes, that was going to hit middle stump. So wicket number two.
Umpire Ahmed Shabab had no doubt in his mind. And they're a man down also. Flying Gorix. Stretcher is being called. Some cramps, in fact. But what an over. Started with a zero, then one leg by, one wide, back-to-back sixes and a wicket. Adnan Ilyas goes for 18. It's 80 for 5. Nafees Shehzad to face the last delivery of the innings. And it is going for at least a couple of runs, or maybe more. The same fielder who was down a couple of minutes back. So it's 2 runs of the last delivery.
The final five overs.
Very interesting this innings. Look at that. Opener Faisal, the top scorer, 27 of 26. His partner went out for duck without facing a ball on the second delivery of the innings. But some fireworks from Arshad and Ilyas, helping them go past that 80 run of that psychological score they would have set for themselves.
Definitely put themselves under a bit of pressure and now have facing a target of 84 runs in their 10 overs. That's 8.4 runs an over. So Flying Oryx will come back and try and get on the Pearl Gladiators. Backed away, batsman Whittle picked up a 4 of the only deliveries faced so far. Left arm round the wicket. Straight to the fielder. Flying Oryx trying to chase that down to get the first victory of the tournament. Outside the leg stump. Almost a paddle sweep there. One in the third over.
Some room given and Hussain finds the gap. The ball finds the boundary ropes.
Outside edge. Hussain Talat riding his luck. He's got a slip, but instead the ball has been hoiked. One bounce into the four.
This is the first six of the innings at the square leg region. Burham taking his team score to 42 for one after four overs. We open the innings. Ball the first over of the innings. Down the track this time. One bounce over the ropes. So Hussain doing more damage for his opponents. This
just a shade over runner ball.
Target looking so easier now. I remember it was 84. The target for Oryx. It looked a little
26 of 16, 47 for 1. Oryx, remember the target for them is 84 to get
30 balls. Missed timing this one, but still good enough to clear the boundary. Second six of the innings, this time from Hussain.
About short delivery there, picked up very easily by Hussain Tharat, and he's hitting boundaries and sixes at will. Still calls for the helmet just inside.
Required run rate below six now.
Look at that. 1, 2, 3. How many bounces? Will not matter. Back-to-back boundaries. What a great over.
Mistimed.
Catch shot down the track this time. This is great shot. We were talking about the mistimed shots, but this is a well-timed shot. Four short of his 50 now.
Shahzad, there you see that four getting right to the pitch of the ball. Didn't want to run after hitting that shot. He was so sure about the boundary. Again, going in the same direction, and this time it's better. Last one was a four, this time got a six, and that's also his 50. 52 of 27. Batsman to get 50 in this 10-over contest. And now Boram decides to join the party. Yes.
He aims for that. But
Flying Oryx didn't disappoint them at all.
Oryx, that too flying. Completely justifying their name. Flying Oryx. Juicy full toss. And this is it. The big one to end the innings for Flying Oryx. And they won the first match of Qatar T10 tournament in style by 9 wickets. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Flying Oryx. Congratulations to Hussain Tharat. And he does it in style. Takes the full toss and sends it into the stands. Those are the people you want to entertain. Missed the catch there, but not that it mattered. 85 for one at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Flying Oryx won the toss, put the opponents into bat, and then won the match by 9 wickets.
पहला मैच इतने धमाके के साथ शुरू हुआ जहां एक तरफ 84 का स्कोर रखा गया वहीं बहुत ही इजीली वेरी क्विकली इनफैक्ट मच बिफोर दे फिनिश एंड द कैप्टन प्लेड अ वेरी वाइटल रोल द वे ही फिनिश द इनिंग इट वाज डेफिनेटली डेफिनेटली कमांडेबल एंड देयर ही इज कैप्टन कम ऑन एवरीबॉडी इट्स टाइम फॉर गिव हिम अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज देयर ही इज तलत हुसैन कांग्रेचुलेशंस So,
thank you so much, captain. Well played. Other captain, other captain.